What up, what up? I'm back at it with another video. So before I get into the video, please hit that like button, hit that subscribe button as well. Today we are going to be talking about digital blackface. What is digital blackface and why are we talking about it? On one of my earlier videos, when I talked about anti-blackness and my quarantine hair and things like that, I got a comment from one of my subscribers by the name of Canelita, and the comment reads, "Talking about these issues has been tricky for me to say the least. There are many times that I call someone out in regards to black issues, but I'm met with a very strange kind of hostility. Not the same kind of hostility that black folks would face, but there's this entitlement that white and non-black people feel when it's by another non-black person. For context, I've gotten into conversations with people regarding things that aren't talked about much, like digital blackface. I've told non-black people not to use reaction images or GIFs of black people because it's digital blackface, but I'm usually told that I cannot tell them not to do that because I'm not black and I'm speaking on black issues. For some reason, I am less credible and they only feel compelled to change a behavior if a black person tells them to, which shouldn't be the case because this obviously falls on black people all the time. And when a couple of black folks say, well, I'm black and I don't have a problem with it, I genuinely don't know how to respond because after all, that's what white and non-black folks want, right? Appropriate a culture and get their token black friends' seal of approval. Ooh. They make us some points. And to be clear, I'm not complaining about any of this. I don't face nearly as much scrutiny as black folks do when they stand up for themselves. I would really appreciate a video on how non-black folks should react, how much should we react, and what to do when one or two black people respond with the fact that they personally do not have a problem with it. Whew. Okay. First of all, I just want to say that was an incredible comment, and I really appreciate you, Canelita, because you always engage with my content, and I appreciate everybody on this channel who engages with the content and leaves meaningful, thoughtful comments and questions, and I welcome more of them in the future. I think a great place to start is, what is digital blackface, right? So digital blackface is a term used to describe digital forms of minstrelsy, performing blackness, performing sassiness, performing exaggerated emotions and things like that. And a lot of people on Twitter and Instagram and various platforms have built up this idea of themselves being a black person, hiding behind maybe avatars of black people, of anime characters, but the way they type, the GIFs that they use, the videos, the memes, that they are presenting as though they are black. They're always using African-American vernacular, and it is a form of minstrelsy. So these are these exaggerated stereotypes of what it is to be a black person. A lot of those stereotypes that already sort of existed in society were then compounded when you had these white actors in blackface performing these actions. To be clear, blackface is racist. In this new digital age where everything is a reaction GIF, or you're trying to be funny, or you're trying to create a brand or a personality online, it really starts to toe this line of, is this racist? A lot of times it is. And it's such a peculiar phenomena because it exists in a long legacy of racism in this country, specifically anti-black racism, when you have to always use black people, black women, black queer people as gifts to get your point across. It starts to come across as very weird. It gets into this very, very weird territory of, why can't you just search for gifts from people who look like you, when white people are who are dominant in this culture, when white people are the majority in this country and in this culture and in media and have been for a very, very long time. And for other people who are not black and who are not white as well, there are gifts that you can likely find of people from your racial or ethnic background. And so it kind of starts to toe the line of, oh, like, I have a inner black woman. And many white gays have said things like this. Oh yeah, I have an inner black woman. Many white women have said this. No, you don't. No, you don't. No, no, you don't. You don't have that. You're not black. Blackness is not a costume. It's not something to just be consumed. Black people are not items. We are human beings. In this country specifically, for so long, we have been constantly dehumanized. And this is just continuing on in that legacy of dehumanization, of turning black people into like these things that you can latch onto in moments when you need something funny, need someone to laugh at. And it's like you're capitalizing off of of either black expression and black labor. On surface level, I think a lot of people is just like, it's not that big of a deal. It's just a gift, right? And I can actually see how someone wouldn't consciously realize that it's not that big of a deal. I can actually see that, especially when you talk about being in certain parts of Twitter, right? If you're in Stan Twitter, or if you're in the LGBT community and, you know, you're in that sort of like bubble, I can definitely see how you wouldn't make those connections and it's not that big of a deal. But you really have to be reflective, and that is what I try to promote on this channel, being reflective. Are all of my gifts mostly of black women? Are all of my gifts mostly of black LGBT people? Is it like a mix? And even personally for myself, I had to really like examine, like, how often am I using black women gifts? Because, like, even though I'm bi and I'm feminine and all of that, like, why am I always going to use black women gifts? Like, do I think that all black women are sassy? And even if I don't think that, is me always using these gifts reinforcing that stereotype? And so it's like one of those tricky ones where you have to really be really reflective. And we're in a different world. We're in a different landscape. There are these different challenges that will come up that have never been seen before. It's about being reflective, but also like it's about understanding how damaging this stuff is. But to answer Kanalita's question, I would say, in those moments, even if you don't have the words to exactly describe why something is wrong, right? And you're not part of that group, but you're trying to, you know, stand up and get people who are not from that group to understand, like, why is this so wrong? You have to say things along the lines of, you know, you want to do the right thing because it's the right thing to do, not only when black people call you out on it. Because that's labor too, right? A black person always having to come up and say, oh, like, this is wrong, this is racist. That's a lot of emotional labor. And this is not some, like, arbitrary thing that we're talking about. This is something that we experience in our day-to-day. This is a personal thing. And also, like, personalizing racist incident. Oh, like, oh, my black friend didn't have a problem when I used this or said this. Well, they might not have had a problem with it. Your individual black friend who doesn't have a problem with it versus like the structure of this, right? Understanding like how this plays into this attitude that society has about blackness and black people, that it is this costume that you can just access and take from and there are no real social repercussions and it's really not that big of a deal. So even if I don't have the words in that moment to argue with someone or to correct someone, what I usually always do is I usually go to Google after those conversations happen and I look up articles written, essays written by people from that group, basically articulating some of my discomfort with what is happening. So I'll give you an example. Sometimes people in my family who are women say misogynistic things, but I don't always have the language to describe like how it is misogynistic. And also sometimes I feel like, it's not really my place, you know, I'm a man. We have a lot of work that we need to do. So I'm not gonna be trying to teach a woman about misogyny, you know what I mean? I need to be learning about misogyny. But I will go and read an article on articulating some of my issues with this particular event. And sometimes I'll send that article to whichever member in my family might have said or done that thing that I thought was like, oh, you probably internalized some misogyny. But what I would say is that, you know, tokenism and exceptionalism are things. So even if your black friends don't have a problem with it, they are most likely used to being under an anti-black society. And so this is just one little thing on top of all the other racist things that they have to deal with. And this one is really not that big of a deal to them, right? So just because one or two or three or whatever black people are like, oh, I'm fine with it, that doesn't necessarily mean that this thing does not affect black people as a whole. And also, it's just about, like, what do you believe is right and wrong? Do you believe that this is right to do X, Y, and Z? You have these conversations of people saying, like, oh, well, I'm more black than you because I listen to hip-hop and I do this. I sag my pants. What are you talking about? No, really, because, like, people think that blackness is a monolith and they think it's an item. How can you, a person who is not black, tell a black person that you are blacker than them? What are you talking about? Like, what are you talking about? What are you saying? It once again tries to put black people in this box that is not human. It takes these moments and these things that are culturally important to some of us and it blows them up and says that that's all that we are. I do have a problem with people who are not black using African American vernacular. When we go to school, our language is policed. We are giving failing grades when we try to use African American vernacular. When we want to get a job, we cannot speak that way. When we exist the way that we do, we are seen as uneducated and we are seen as not worthy. We create and it's demonized and policed. So when you talk about things like sagging your pants, do you not remember when stop and frisk was a law, especially in New York, was going to make it illegal to sag your pants and you would get a fine and you would get harassed and arrested by police? Y'all don't understand the levels of anti-blackness that resides within you. And that was part of why I made that video too, because I was just trying to process. This stuff goes deep. It is criminalized. I am seen as uneducated. I have to prove how intelligent I am, whatever intelligence is, right? Even when I am proving my intelligence, it's always this surprise. Wow, you're so articulate. Everyday racism, people are surprised. It's so wild that that happens, the policing happens, the constant underpaying for our labor, the fact that we have to oftentimes learn different dialects. So there's a way that you speak at home, but then when you come to school, you have to speak in a completely different way. And so you have words like code switching to describe that switch, right? And it really describes sort of fitting into society. It describes social mobility. You won't be able to move throughout society safely if you don't know how to code switch as a black person. So many of us have had to develop that. And then you have people who are not black coming along, and now y'all are trying to use it to get likes and views on social media. It's such a mind and racist. I don't really have the words, really. Well, those are some of my thoughts. That was kind of a lot. But I really, really appreciate this question. If you made it this far in the video, please leave me some hearts down in the comment section below. And if you would like to help me out in any way, my Cash App and my Venmo is right down below in the description box. Also, I do have a wish list. So if you would like to help me out by just, you know, getting me something, I would love that as well. And that's right down below. So I'll see you all next time. Peace.